And this paint schedule will work both for a skin or a reproduction. If it's a reproduction, I'd white it and then I'd put my brown back in. Skin mount, I pretty much already got my brown on there. And if you were doing a reproduction, you would just paint him brown and get him lighter as you go down towards the fins, and probably stop right just above the fins. You know, the belly area is always white, and where the belly comes up to the side, make a stopping point. You can tell on most trout, there's kind of a stopping point, and you know where to stop your colors. And that's the same way on this fish with your brown. But right now I've got just a little bit of pearl. It's already got kind of a pearly effect, and I thought, well, I'll just add a little bit more of it. And here again, if I was doing a reproduction, I'd probably use just a real strong pearl, like silver pearl, or I mean a silver metallic, and pearl him up pretty good. But since we've already got the brown on there, then we don't have to worry about putting so much of the pearl on there. If you're doing a reproduction, you'd have to put the brown on there, but our brown step has already been eliminated because it's a skin mount. And you save on paint too. And that's one way to look at it. But I do like to, a lot of these areas are real pearly anyway. Okay, I've also got some white, and what I'm going to do is whiten up his belly a little here. You always have to worry about that dead look. I do not like the dead look. And that's why you may opt to paint him solid white first. For the dead look. I probably would have. The only thing, you're going to use a little bit more paint, and if you notice on these fish, the belly comes down just basically right here at the bottom. Of course, this white feather's up on the side a little bit. And you can control how much white you put on your fish. And what that does, that also controls if you want to whiten your controls the darkness of your fish. If you're afraid your fish looks too dark and kind of a little bit dead looking, I guess, use the white. You can use the white to your own intensity. If you got a lot of fin work, then you can, or you think your fins kind of have a dead look, you can put the colors back in later. A lot of people, when they do a tinning method, they'll leave the fins the same color, and I don't, because I think the fins have kind of a dead look. And even on the more regular fish, like a bass or something, I will still wipe the fins out, because I like a fin. When you're doing a tinning method, that really makes the fin look better. And you've got to pull out all your stops, so to speak. The tinning method, a lot of times, around these juncture areas around the mouth, I'll tend to brighten them up, because, like say on a bass or something, later on down the road, you'll get that real dead orange look, and that's where it's going to be, is right there around these little junction areas, around the maxillary and the lower jaw and certain places. I would go ahead and paint the whole mouth white. Here again, if you want to, you can paint your whole fish white. Or if you want to lighten your fish up, go over it with a little bit of white. You have got so many options And you put it on light enough, a white brings out what's white and makes a little bit whiter. Both sides of the fins. Get them real good and white. Even the dorsal and the tail. Now yellow ochre is opaque, and you may want to save your white and go over it with the yellow ochre. And that's going to cover up a lot of your dead skin look too, because yellow ochre is such an opaque color. But anytime you can cheat a little bit and use original marks on a fish without sacrificing the quality of your fish, go ahead and use it. And that's what I like to do most of the time. And that's one thing about Del Hollow Lake. You've got a little bit of everything. This is probably the most southernmost range that you will find a lake trout. And even down here, they're not in great numbers. Make sure you get the mouth good and wide. And now right around these junction areas, okay, now remember, I went back to my purl, and what I do, even on a lot of my tinning, on my tinning method on a lot of my bass, if you put a little bit of purl down, it gives the purl something to reflect off of. It's the opposite of an iridescent. An iridescent will reflect off dark colors better than a white color. Well, purl reflects better off white. And so I went back to my purl to give the fish even more of a little bit of a pearly look. And what it does is that purl is reflecting off of the white that we missed on there. And that's what purl is real good for doing. And you get the belly real good, around the face. And what we're doing, we're just giving it a real good pearly look. And I've done several reproductions, and it doesn't bother me if my paint doesn't go exactly where I want it to go, because I know we've got more colors going on. And since I've done reproductions, I know where to carry my colors, and we're going to cover up any overspray with our white or our pearl. So I don't let it bother me like it might some people, but just for that reason. Real good and curly. Even a little on the fins. Turn the fish up sideways and get the belly. Now again, I put the pearl on, I guess about a medium coat on the belly, and just put a little bit more over the white, just to get it to reflect the pearl quality. Now you remember the end result of this fish, you're going to be able to see all these colors going to come forward when you put your gloss on. And so you got to be careful, especially with your iridescence and with your pearls. You can put them on so heavy you can mess a fish up with the iridescence. I've got the dark brown here. I've used rich brown before. But if you feel like you want your... You can go over it a little bit with the more dark brown if you want to. And you can cover up, or you can tone in some of your, if you've got a lot of repair work that you've done, you can tone it in a little. You may opt for rich brown. It's rich brown's pretty close too. But you may want to go over some of your brown marks, and if you put on light enough, what it does, it brings out some of those marks a little bit better. Just misting. For it's over, you don't have to. The only thing is, if you were doing a reproduction, you would have to put all these in. And I don't worry about the fins, because I'll replicate the fins anyway. And I kind of leave the belly alone, but the belly goes down pretty far on these fish. I mean, just directly underneath. And a lot of people will even still miss a little bit of brown under there to off the white color. Now we're off to our next color. I got yellow ochre, and I use it for my fins, and it's a good color for any fin, actually. Yellow ochre is always a good color for fins. On a lot of fish. And I can see a hint of yellow in the fins on my fish. So about a medium light coat, I guess. Regular yellow would probably work. I've used it before. Same with these fins. About a white coat. It's easy to put way too much on there. You're not careful. And make sure you do the bottoms of them too. The thing about trout, you got two sides that show on a trout. And if you didn't paint your fins white, then you definitely want to make sure that you use yellow on your fins. For that better, especially if you didn't paint your fins white first. And you want to put a medium to light coat, probably even a little bit lighter than what I'm putting on. It'd be fine. Sometimes that's good, because you can just put your black in where you see your black on your fins. And so I can understand why a lot of people will leave their fins bare, because it gives them something to go by, even on the fins it does. Because you can see where the black was at on the fins. We're fixing to put other colors over it anyway. But if you want to, you can. Probably more so around the belly, because there's definitely a yellow color right here around the belly. And I suppose if you wanted to, you could go ahead and put a little bit back in there. But we're going to go back to some yellow later. Okay, now I've got medium green. And I'm going to put this along the back. I'm We go around the eyes. With about a medium to light coat. You want a light coat would be better. But you want to see it too, so. Remember, we're painting in layers. Now this medium green is an opaque color. So if you're wanting to use some of your original body marks on your fish, you want to be careful with it, because you can cover your marks up in a hurry. So you want just a light coat anyway, all the way down to where we carried our brown. Just kind of green everything up a little. Right here. And that's about good enough, believe it or not, just like that. We just want to put our colors on kind of light. We don't want to put them on too heavy. Probably about a light coat's about what you want. Yeah, even the maxillary. And you want to also put some on the fins. You don't want to kill your red yellow out completely, but you want it to make it look like a deep yellow green. Just a hint of the yellow coming through. And yeah, that's good. Because in my references, I see a little bit of green. Sometimes I have to look for a minute. I can't tell if it's really green or blue. And sometimes these marks on the fish look almost like a black green. I wouldn't doubt if you could get away with using black green as a color. Maybe darken some of these of the body up on the side anyway. Okay, I'm just gonna haze this yellow out a little bit more. And that's about right there. Still green, still got a yellow tint. About like you would on a, say, a brown trout or something. You want a little bit of that greenish hue to show up, even though you're going to have other colors on it. If you can master that, that's pretty good. Probably more towards the inner. But green is a good hiding quality. Sometimes it's a good thing if you want to get rid of some kind of a dead look. This kind of opaque green can really do the job for you. Also right here, you want to kind of carry the green back a little far, about like that. You don't want to get too carried away, but extend it a lot farther than you would, like say, on a bass or something. Just look at a good reference picture. If you look on a good reference picture, your maxillaries as well as that lower jaw are pretty well defined. And all of this isn't the last color we're going to use. The later subsequent colors, it's going to make a difference. Let some of the overspray come down on these other rays. Don't get too carried away.
If you look at a reference picture, it shows you all that. It even shows you where you want your overspray to hit.
Next color is going to be Payne's Gray, and it's one of the main colors on a fish. But here again, you got to determine what color your fish is. Some of them tend to lean more towards the green side, some a little bit more on a brownish side, and then some on a Payne's Gray side. Payne's Gray is a good color. All this color up here is a Payne's Gray. These are reference pictures. And if you look at these, now this one shows more of the green color that's prevalent, almost like a black green. But here again, you can see the yellow. The head has the top of the back is definitely Payne's Gray. So you've got to find a balance in between the Payne's Gray and the green, black green, and then the medium green type color, which a lot of them portray. So you just got to reach a good balance there according to what your fish is. Okay, now I've got Payne's Gray. And I'm just going to go along the back for starters. Then, of course, we've got to go down the side. Hits the yellow that we put on, it's still going to have somewhat of a greenish look to it anyway. Because when Payne's Gray goes over the green, it's gonna make everything real kind of green. When Payne's Gray goes over the yellow that was already on there, try to make complete strokes. Try to avoid uneven places on your fish, in other words. And if we have to, we'll go back and widen some of the areas we're just happy with, as I can still see a reflective of that pearl coming through. And so that's going to even look better when we kind of darkening up the green that was already on there. And this Payne's Gray, we're going to have to go over a lot of this with black to darken it up even more. Here's my Payne's Gray. Now what I would do if I were you, find one picture that's got the color of the fish that you want it to be and use that for your reference.
at least for your base coat. Because if you don't, you're going to be switching between several different kinds of fish, and it just sounds like it's more of a mess than you want. Okay, I'm going over this. This is my Payne's gray, and where it's going over that yellow, it's now I'm going to concentrate on the back a little. And you can even make a Payne's gray color by using blue. And this that almost looks like a black green anyway. I'm about where I need to be. I'm going to darken the back a little bit more. But as I was saying, you can make a Payne's gray color out of blue with some black in it. And get about the same color. That is if you don't have any. A lot of times if you don't have a paint, that doesn't mean you can't paint your fish. That means you just got to mix some of the colors of what you got. I run into that quite often. Now depending on your reference, sometimes these fish are real dark around the eyes. Right here, and especially right in there. And I suppose you could go ahead and bring out some detail in your fins with this while you've got it. Now remember where your spotting is going to be. Look at your reference picture. And it'll tell you a lot. I'll just wait and use black. On the reference picture you use, they all vary in intensity, the colors, the fin colors, everything. And as I said earlier, some of the fins show you exactly where you need to put your colors if you didn't paint them right first. They almost show you where you need to put your colors. This light green on this fin could be a little better. I like that light green color. All fish differ. Their colors differ a lot. Okay, I've got my black, and what I've done, I've darkened up some areas that seemed a little too bluish green looking. I smoked up the bottom of my fin rays. Now we're going to put white spotting on there. It's going to give a good illusion. So you want to make sure you take this back far enough, but not too much. We're fixing to put our white spotting on, so we want to make sure basically that all our fins are done good enough. With a little bit of black here and there on both sides. Now you want to look at reference to determine that this is just straight black. It determines where you put your black on your fins, which is more in the center than anything. And we're going to touch it up later. And this is also a pretty good color. A black green would work too. It's a good color to go ahead and get the back of your, the fins that are carded anyway, go ahead and cover them. Your seam, go ahead and get that out of the way while you're at it. You can wait and do this at last, or you can do it now while you've got the black. You can even smoke the belly a little if you want to with this. Just to give it a spray, you'll bring in the scale pattern, especially along the belly. See how that's a real good effect. What it's doing, see the scales tend to run at an angle, and it brings the scales out that way, and it has a real good effect. Go ahead and smoke him up a little if you want to. You don't want to get too carried away, but you want to take advantage of the fact that he's a real fish, use the scales, and we'll show you what we're going to do next. Sometimes there's kind of a brownish color under here that shows. And I don't think it's wrong to try to incorporate that little bit of brownness back in. A lot of times it's more of a yellow, mainly towards the bottom part, even down on the belly a little bit. Kind of smoke it up a little with the rich brown. And that's good enough right there. We're going to get a little bit of a hint of it. As you can see, I can plainly see my white spotty through my other paint that I've put on here. And I've done that on purpose. Now that's the main difference between a reproduction or a skin. The advantage that I have with a skin mount is I can see my spots and I'll just put them back in. And the disadvantage you would have, or I would have, if I was doing a reproduction, would be that I would have to have a good reference picture and put him in as close and as exact as the reference picture I've got allows. They tend to be kind of come up from the wild on the belly, and that's a real good effect. Matter of fact, I've done a reproduction, and I might be able to show you that. Something to go by. I'm going to go ahead and put all my white spots in. I wanted to get my base coats about right. Down here, a little bit more browner looking. I don't know if you see it on tape. But you can see a little bit of a brown haze. And as you get up, it's a little bit more of the dark, I guess, Payne's grayish type look. And so now we're going to go ahead and get started with our spotting, which is really what's going to make the fish. Now, find you a good reference picture if you can, preferably with the turn that you want. And I know that's going to be easier said than done for a lot of people, but thin your paint down real good and start putting your marks. And so here's a good one, but it's the other turn, but I could still use it. And that's why it's always good to find a reference picture that has it where he's turned the other way. It helps out a lot more. Probably a good idea. Now I put so many colors on that I've covered up my skin. Okay, I'm starting here at the maxillary. And you probably want to turn adjust your paint where it's not flowing so heavy. You can go ahead and wipe your teeth up. That's a very good idea, actually. because they're supposed to be white anyway. I've got to adjust my airbrush. The reproduction or not, still got to put these, a reproduction head or not, I always tend to do a couple of things. And this is one of them. I tend to go around the maxillary, I trace it out. Go all the way up like that. Go around the maxillary and go around the upper part of the lip, which is about from right here. Tends to go around like that. Here again, find your good reference picture and get ready to do the inevitable, that which you've got to do, which is put all the marks in. Either put them in or trace them in. The skin mount, you know, even on the face a lot of times, especially if you use an artificial head, which most people do nowadays, you still do have to put them in. But I'm just following what the reference picture shows. Let's see, it starts here at the bottom. Now you don't want the fuzzy look. You want them to look real. You want them strong white with not so fuzzy edges, which takes a little airbrush control. But that means the difference between a good paint job, and you might even have to hold with your other hand. Hold your breath or whatever you got to do it. You gotta really make sure your paint's working right for this. Maybe here on the lower lip. Now you're going to fight with your airbrush for a while to get it right. as crisp as possible because it makes for a better mount. And if you got a bent needle, that makes it a little worse, which I do. But you get the idea. And where it turns white, there's almost like a little bit of a modeling effect with your white, so you just kind of blend it in that way a little. Here is real white, seems like. Now, some of them are pretty circular, some of them aren't. Any shortcuts, I'm getting it exact, and even a little bit of a flow, how the mark itself, how it relates to the cheek, sometimes there's a little bit of a flowage to them, and I'm putting all that in there. So you just find a good reference picture and start replicating. And okay, here's what I got so far on the head, and basically what I done, I used a real picture and tried to get the flow of the spots. The spots will go in a certain way, and then another spot will go next to it in a certain way, kind of interrelate to it a little bit. But there's also some stuff down here that we need to put in. And it's like spotting also, so we want to get that as close as we can. And here's what it looks like. Sort of want to do all the rows until you get down. The next row is the same thing. And when you put the white on, it gives the illusion that the black, that the darkness is what's making the spot, so. And just go all the way down and do that. It has such a good realistic effect that it needs to be done. And that's why I carried the paint down as far as I did. It was for a reason, and this is it. It tends to give it
that mottled effect, and that's what you want.
Now you can trim all this out. I think I'll do this back one and probably this one only. Kind of like that. And I'm going to leave well enough alone. I guess you could trim it here too. And I usually trim all in here too, each one of those. But if your friend's going to mess up your effects, you might just want to leave it as it is. But we got around the maxillary. And a lot of times I usually go up in here and go in between all these. But I'm going to leave well enough alone. And now we start on the body. These spots, which helps out a lot. But they tend to get more irregular and a little bit bigger at the belly. A little bit more irregular and bigger. Here again, find a good reference picture. If you can't see the marks, then use whatever you can. Now here at the bottom, the way they transition up has a neat looking effect. And you probably want to keep that as much as possible. Do kind of like that, and you can actually see the marks. And if you don't have a good reference picture, make sure you get a good reference picture and try to get those as good as possible. Right in here, they tend to flow this way, so you incorporate that. Pretty good size long ones, so you may want to connect a couple of these. And if you incorporate your own, you're still getting the right effect. Now the spot pattern has to be realistic, because that's what makes the fish. And so you want a realistic spot pattern. Above the pectoral, they start breaking up. But below it, there's all kinds of stuff. Some of them just kind of come up and tend to go backwards. You can see the effect you're getting. You're getting the effect you want. And you've still got some pretty magnificent looking spots up here. And make sure the spot pattern looks real. Do your thing. Now up here, there's the separation of the spots after you reach above these bottom fins, right above the junctures. There's more room between the spots, although the spots get bigger. I can see it. And as you get towards the lateral line, they start getting smaller again. And then above the lateral line, they get even smaller. So you just want to replicate those as good as you can. I'm just going over my spots. But there again, I've done real good replicas just by, sometimes you can't see the spots anyway, but to the back as high as you want to go. A lot of people don't go all the way up on the back because it's going to be so dark anyway. So I take it up to about here. And a lot of times, especially on a replica, a good effect is to make the spot smaller and more dispersed. And it gives illusion that the darkness of the back is kind of taking over. That, I've seen people do that. That's pretty good. Spots with another color kind of help blend them into the back also. So you've got little options there. Now right along the back, above the lighter line, they start getting a little bit lighter. And, elongated or something like that.
and you want the spots to be uniform in where they break up at and their size differential. In other words, the bigger towards the belly, and above the lateral line, they start getting small again. Although still irregular, some of them. Darkness to start taking over as you get up towards the top of the back. And if you noticed, this one doesn't have an adipose fin. It was a hatchery fish. But if it was, you'd do the same thing with it. Maybe put a few small dots that would eventually get covered over with some color. Uniform the way I'm breaking them up towards the back. Area without no spots and another area with a whole lot of spots. You just gotta, takes a little bit of a conscious effort to pay close attention to the belly area. The way the marks, you could do better than this even, but the way the marks come off of the belly, you can even make those look more realistic than what they are. The fin's got markings. Here again, the better job you want to do, the more close you're going to replicate a picture. And that's pretty much about the way to say it. A lot of them are kind of lines. A lot of times I just use spots. But here again, you can do pretty good even. Just get your airbrush down real good. Couple little spots in there too. A lot of people just do the spotty, which that would be okay too. Now we're going to do all fins like this too. Right down the front here. I'm going to hold your breath if you have to. I'm going to replicate that. Get the lower portion of the fin. You want to carry it up where the rays are. You kind of carry it up where the rays come down. It kind of looks pretty good that way. Kind of go where the rays are, and as you get toward the end, just very, 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 very easy. About like that. About like you do an arctic charting. Take that first couple of spines and go down and really make the fish look like something. And I'm going to show you what we do in the other fins. Fin. Find you a good reference picture. out like a Charles too. You got two white outer edges, sometimes a real deep orange. Sometimes it don't show that much, and other times it shows pretty good. But you carry them out like that, the next row doesn't go quite as far out. And you do the top the same way. And you may want to go all the way out like that in the next row. Now there's spotting all over the fins. You may want to make it like they're exploding out. You know, kind of a rough sort of pattern. And it's got kind of a wavy look, but it's see, it still looks kind of like it's some kind of pattern to it. I put a couple out here and then I just made kind of a staggering pattern. The next row. And you can even kind of make the spots elongated just a hair. So a little bit slightly elongated. It's not wrong to lighten the outer edges because I've seen them not only on char but on a lot of your trout. Not all of them, but a lot of them. The thing with this fin, about like all trout, and pelvic fins on both sides. Take the first couple of spines. If you have to, hold your breath. And then put your spotting on. The first front row. Goes all the way down to the end. About like that, and you do your other one the same way. On both sides. Take that front row. Okay, that's pretty good. Take that first one all the way down to the end. Just kind of break it up like that. And do all your pins that way on both sides. How the back looks, the top of the back. The spots right up here on top are dark in the back, and you're still getting the illusion that the back's darker, because there's less and smaller spots. Now I've got my rich brown again. And I'm gonna apply just up to above the pectorals. It's right here on the bottom. You can even see it where I wanna put it. It's right here along the bottom. Where we put it before, and you put it on light enough, it has a real good effect. You don't want to make your white too bad. You could probably go ahead and put a pass or two over the whole fish, but you mainly want to concentrate it right down here. Okay, that's about right. Color of your fish, you can go up higher with it. You can go all over the fish with it. You're kind of swapping around between the Payne's gray, the green, and the brown. And so all that stuff you're toning in to the color of your fish. But whatever color your fish is. What I've got is bright yellow. And I suppose yellow ochre would work for this too. Bright yellow is a little bit more transparent, and that's what I like about it. And I'm just kind of blending it in at the very bottom. I ain't going on the belly with it, but right up here in the bottom, I want that yellow to show vaguely. You want just a vague. Now you can go over all your spots lightly, at least up to the ladder line, but more heavy right there where you put the rich brown, maybe a little on the face, and slightly up here. What you're doing, you're changing the values of your spots, but mainly focus right down on here. About a medium to light coat. And then as you get towards the ladder line, you want it that color to fade out. Because we want the pain spray to make the spots kind of blue, and we want that blue to fade into that yellow. And if it's all yellow, then you're going to get green instead of blue, so you got to be careful with that. From a distance, you know, with looking at the camera, all the spots tend to come together. And that's an optical illusion because of the camera. So what we're wanting to do, I'm going over the back with the Payne gray, which we've already established. And what I'm doing is I'm bluing them spots. And there's other blues that you could do this with, but since I'm darkening the back with Payne's gray anyway, although the back is pretty well about as dark as I wanted it, carry this color down. It's about the lateral line. Not so much, because we got that designated area. You just want a little bit of a blue effect. And you can do all your fins that way. Mainly what you're doing, you're making the spot a little bit blue looking. Even around the eye here. And by the time you get to the lateral line, you want it completely faded out. In other words, it's possible to put it on too strong. Now you want that blue of that Payne spray to fade out at the lateral line about a light coat. You don't want to wash the spots up too much. Just give them a slight bluish kind of color. I wanted to give my put a little bit more yellow. So I got my transparent yellow to change the value of my water a little bit. And I went just below the back with it to blend it down here a little bit better. And kind of blend that Payne gray in a little bit, make it more of a green. And that's what I've got right here. And I'm not touching the back so much with it. Leaving the Payne's gray around the eye and a little bit around the cheek area. Maybe a little misty. You just want to make it where it shows a little bit of the green in there too. You don't want to make it green, you can get carried away. Got a light coat. Something I should have already done is put orange to the fins before I put my spots on. But that's okay, we'll just have to go over spots again with more white. Now this is optional. A lot of people leave their fins yellow. Here again, let your fish be your guide. His bottom belly is about almost like a splake. So you just got to keep that in mind. Orange on the inside of the fin, and that's accurate. But that's pretty accurate, just like that. My angle spray to hit the rays from the corner, and this bright orange is so opaque that it really has a good effect. You don't want to thin it down none, because it's barely opaque enough as it is.
bottom of this tail. It's a little bit harsh. And the same with the top. The ends here. That's optional. But at least this and that tail. And some to match up those fins, a person will put a little bit along the lower belly. Optional, you might want to leave your fins white. But if you feel like you want to match the fins a little bit, get your orange, put maybe a hair along the lower belly where we put the brown and the yellows earlier, and just to try to blend that in a little bit. Now where I messed my fin up, where I messed up the white on the outer edge, I'm going to go ahead and put it back in. You might want to go back over your spots even, if you feel you need to. Just lightly. And you also want to trim the outer edges back. I got to do the other two that way too. Just like we did the first time before we put the horn. You may want to leave these feet. For you want to take just that very, very little corner right here. Fade out about like that. Fade out about halfway up the fin, or even maybe about a third up the fin on this side. But at any rate, as you get towards the back of it, take a smaller chunk of the fin as you go. And do all your other fins the same way. All your other bottom fins the same way. Right here, the lower third. Take a bigger chunk right here on the point. And get towards the back of the fish. Take a smaller and smaller and smaller bite. About like that. Now I angle sprayed with a bright orange from this way, and it highlighted the rays, and that's a real good effect, and it shows on real fish. But I washed out some of my other colors. I put my spots back in, so-so. But then I hit from this way with my black, and I made sure I didn't get on the white. And even if I did, I just go back and put more white here. But I hit the black from this edge, and it took out the washed out effect. But I hit this one with a bright orange, and it shows almost like bright streaks. And I done that to all my fins. Get that real hot orange look on the ends of the fins. I'll tell you this a little bit. I put a little bit of black on it, and a little bit on the dorsal also. I
try to kill out those spots, and I angle sprayed and hit the fins from an angle. Something I generally don't mess with, but if you see any kind of pearl or iridescence, I've got a little turquoise pearl, and I might mist it and stop at the ladder line or just above, about a half inch above the ladder line, just to give them, and don't even go up on the back with it, and just give a little bit of a iridescent, I've got just a little bit of turquoise pearls what I use, and I'd say iridescent green would be good. If now you want to clean the eye off, get a little bit of lacquer thinner, just a drop or two on a Q-tip, and you want to roll the excess out on a paper towel, and now you clean the eye off. Now, if you were doing a complete artificial replica where you paint the whole fish white and then pearl it, after the pearl, I would go ahead and clean your eye off, because if you don't, when you re-clean your eye off, at the end, you'll have a white ring around your eye. And okay, now I've got the gloss top coat. And you can pull back on the needle about a half inch, and but you'll get full blast with your gloss, and you might not want that, but I use polyurethane gloss anyway, so I just use this for one step only, and that's to set the paint. Then I'll go over with polyurethane gloss or wet look gloss or some other, but you can use this and just go over it with layers. But with a regular airbrush, by the time you get to the other parts of your fish, the top coat you just put on is already dry. And I guess to a lot of people that's kind of aggravating. But I use it to set the paint anyway, so I don't care. And then I go over with some polyurethane gloss. Now there's glosses out there you don't want to use because they'll shimmer too much and reflect everything behind you. You want something that'll shine but give you depth. And so I just put this on light. I don't want to put it on real wet. And I can even see the silver metallic coming through. Or the pearl we put on. And I like that. That's really good. And I can even see the turquoise pearl that we put on too. So you just want to set the paint everywhere, put it on all the pins. Then you can either put it back on in layers. If you got a gloss gun, you can put your gloss top coat on and do it right the first time. It'll look good. But if you don't have one, or you like using the other stuff, which I do, then set your paint with that. Go back over it with a heavier coat of gloss top coat or whatever your other kind of